Happy Friday and welcome to the Creative Studio. I am Kim Kesty here at Spellbinders and excited to be here as we try to do every Friday. Just experiment with something new, maybe get your creative juices flowing. We broadcast live on Facebook and YouTube, so definitely if you're on YouTube, you can check those little buttons that just popped up and like us and subscribe and share and get notified and all those good things. It really helps our channel out, so that's really cool. So today we have been talking all week long here at Spellbinders about Susan's new collection. This is Susan Tierney Coburn, and she does those beautiful realistic flowers. If you're not really familiar with her, she has Susan's, she calls it Susan's Garden, which is very appropriate. And we've been talking about that on the blog and different things all week long. So I thought, ta-da, I'm going to try this on Try-Day Friday today. So I'm using one of her amazing dyes. I'm going to show it to you right now and we'll get started playing. So one of her popular ones, and as Susan herself has said, the poinsettia is one of the quintessential holiday flowers. And I learned something by just watching her video. So by the way, Susan has YouTube videos that she creates, both on her own channel, and we have them here on the Spellbinders channel, where she goes through in detail creating all of her flowers and all of her different items. But I was watching her YouTube on how to create this poinsettia, and it was really fun. She had so many fun facts in there. But the poinsettia itself, as far as this being a flower, it's not really a flower. You've probably noticed this, as I have, but I never really paid attention, that all these petals on the outside are actually all leaves. And the only part that's the flower is the little tiny itty bitty part in the middle. So there's your trivia for the day. So these flowers are kept in the dark until about 6 weeks before they're ready to be for sale during the holiday season. They come out into the sunshine and they turn different colors. So I am going to be practicing on a red poinsettia today, but as you can see by this, and I'm going to show you a project later on, of course poinsettias come in pinks and whites and light pinks and all kinds of fun things. But Susan's dyes are really cool. This set has 5 dyes in it, so it's fairly simple as far as her flowers go. Some are a little bit more complicated, so I felt kind of confident that I could try to tackle this poinsettia. But again, after watching her video, she really walks through all of them. But the dyes have a unique marking on them, and maybe you've seen this before, but you can see right there, Frank comes in really close. Sorry, Roy. Just talking to Frank. That's funny. So it has this little marking on it that says 2 times. So that is very easy identification to how many times you need to cut this out. So I'm going to cut the large one 2 times, the little one 1 time. There's some extra leaves and petals here, depending on where you want to add them to your little flower. And then, of course, this is the actual flower part that's very much in the middle. Now, I want to show you the paper I cut it out of real quick. And, of course, it makes all the difference in the world, really, as far as creating Susan's flowers. This is Susan's Garden Specialty Cardstock. So we sell this here at Spellbinders. I believe it's in packs of 10. Yep, 10 sheets, it says right there. And then just to kind of show you after I've die cut my poinsettias out here. And again, I think we did one video on Susan's thing a long time ago and he got in really close and we showed you the texture of this paper. It's a little bit lighter than our heavy cardstock as far as weight wise, but it has this really cool texture. And that's probably hard to see on the video, but it's really beautiful and it comes to life when you do add color to the flowers. So again, you're going to have the most success if you use this amazing specialty cardstock by Susan. Whereas, like, I'm determined, I'm going to get it. Kim, quit moving it. But it has a nice little, kind of a stipple, I guess I'll call it a stipple effect. So, I did mention that you cut this out 2 times, but you actually would cut it out 2 times for the red part of your flower, or whatever the color is, and an additional 2 times, 1 or 2 times for the green part that goes behind your poinsettia. So you'll see as I kind of put the flower together that you're going to have a few different options here. So what I've got is a couple of Copic markers here. And I'm just really going to color one flower. I don't want to take too much time coloring. And again, Susan will walk you through all of that amazing coloring. But it's really pretty simple. She just uses a Copic marker, and this particular one happens to be R46, and I think this is the same one she used in her video. And you just color the paper, and again, once you add the color, it does pop out that texture a little bit more than as you manipulate the paper into the flower shape. You're going to see even more of that. So I'm just kind of following the lines of the flower. I'm not being you know, super delicate coloring this or anything. But you do want to get color on there, and because the flowers are so beautifully shaped, you're going to want to color both sides of the die cut. So I'll quickly go through and cut the other side. Color the other side as we go along. So how are you guys doing this Friday? Are you having your end of the summer blues? Are you happy the cooler weather is coming? Mid-September now, we should see some cooler weather. Of course, in Phoenix here, we don't really look forward to that till October. But everywhere else, I think, is starting to see fall. But I've been doing Christmas cards for a few weeks now, and definitely feels like gets me in the mood, you know, for fall. Have you started any Christmas cards yet? Are you a Christmas in July person, or are you a let's wait person? So I'm just going to move my little nonstick pad. I'll wash that off. So again, just really, you know, easy breezy. Color that poinsettia. And then what you're going to want to do is, I have Susan's toolkit here. I guess I'll just give you a whole peek of the toolkit. So this has all kinds of the goodies in there. Tweezers and the specialty tool-in-one with the special tips on it. One I have already on here, and this is the leaf pad tool. It's a little nice little curved pointer. This is a foam pad that I'm going to use in a minute to shape my flowers, but this is a leaf pad. And it's a super thick, really nice piece of I don't know what you call it, paperboard. It's a specialty piece, and it's perfect for coming in because your leaf tool is quite, you know, pointy, but this allows you to come in and just get some really nice texture just by going right along the center of that leaf. I shouldn't call it a flower, right? Because we just learned that even the red ones are called leaves. And this is just like I'm pushing pretty hard into this leaf pad. And it's allowing me to put that center line all the way down. You can even go over it a couple times. Now Susan comes in and she does the back side also, and I find this a little bit tricky to try to follow the lines, but I've been practicing and I'm getting better. Susan recommends that if you do this, then it just makes the impression a lot deeper, which is definitely true. Then you'll also be able to kind of shape your leaf along that line, which basically is kind of like a score line. You'll start to be able to shape your red poinsettia leaf here. But before I get too crazy shaping it, I do want to come in with the little leaves and also do some veining. So I'm going to start in the middle and kind of curve some veining out, sort of like it would look on a poinsettia leaf, right? Now, I don't know if those show up super good in the video. I'll do one more over here. The leaf tool also is slightly curved, so it helps you with this. And you don't have to do tons of them, but I kind of follow the little dimples of the outline here and get some nice little veining. All right, so I'm going to set this one aside. It's not quite done yet. Oh, actually, yeah, I'm going to set this one aside. I'm going to bring one in that I have already done with all the veining, kind of little shaping, and you can even take the little tweezers in the kit and slightly bend these tips over, and that just makes the shape of it really pretty. Isn't that nice? And then I'm going to bring in one of our fun artsy tools that we've had here. This is originally from Fun Stamper's Journey. This is Pan Pastel, so all these little pastels come in one kit right here. This happens to be the Party Pop collection, so it has a little bit brighter colors, but this green is really a pretty green. So I'm just going to bring some green in, because remember what I said about the poinsettia originally being green until it's brought out into the light. So this could still have some green, you know, which you see too when you see poinsettias, right? And this also kind of highlights the middle of that kind of veining in the poinsettia. So just a little bit of that green is just so pretty. I've done a green leaf already, and I've already brushed some Pan Pastel in there, but here's a single leaf. I'll just kind of do the same thing. Just brush a little of the Pan Pastel. Again, it just makes that vein in the middle just pop a little bit more. Yeah, I'll turn it that way. There we go. See how that pops? The color just kind of pops out when you add the pastel. So fun. So I've got my little baby one. I've got two big ones. And then an extra leaf here. I think they all have the green on them now. Yep, they do. So again, I chose to do two of the larger red ones, just a single green one, and then a couple extra leaves. So that's going to be the basis of my poinsettia leaves. Now this little fun die, you might be wondering, okay, Kim, what are you going to do with this little guy? So this you only cut once, again, out of the same specialty paper. See, I've got it cut out right here. And what's fun about this guy is then we can add one of our newer products we're carrying here at Spellbinders to give this little guy some really fun dimension. I'm going to bring back my little foam pad here. So after I cut these out, I colored them with a marker. By the way, the marker, I'm going to just share the greens I used. I used YG99, which I think is the one that Susan uses a lot. And then I used a little bit of the BG96 also, just to have two tones of green, but you wouldn't really have to do that. So I colored these the same way, both sides green. And then I took one of our newer products. And I'm actually not 100% sure if this is launched on the site yet. I think it might be going live today or tomorrow. So definitely check out the website and make sure. But these are Nuvo drops, and they've been around the craft community for a little while. And we thought, how fun. We're going to pick out some of Susan's favorites. I think we picked up 9 or 10 colors. And we're going to bring them in and sell them because they go so beautifully with Susan's Garden Club. So we thought that would be really fun. So these two, I actually ended up only using the green, but this one Susan really likes. And this is Autumn Red. But again, the one I used is the Olive Branch. So you can definitely check those out. And if they're not in yet, you can hit notify me, but they will be just momentarily on the website, I am sure. So just kind of dimensional little drops. You can see right here that I just dropped them on the end of the little die cut. I just did a little squeeze. These are already dry. I did them earlier. But they're just beautiful. They're dimensional. They're textured. They just add so much life. And guess what? I even did it on both sides. That's what Susan recommends. So you do it on one side of the die cut, let it dry, and then do it on the other side. And that's fun. So these guys just layer up similar to the way these flowers are going to layer up, but I'm going to go ahead and start doing that. I have the medium ball tip here, and I'm just going to kind of poke that in the middle and shape that paper a little bit. That's going to go in the middle of my poinsettia. Same with this little guy. And then the last piece right here, Susan is so thoughtful in her design. She said add a little bit of glue. I'm just going to add a smidge of glue here. And then this little tab right here is actually meant to be a little piece for your tweezers to hold. I love that she thought of that. And then you can just roll this guy up. And this is actually going to become the very, very center of the flower of your poinsettia. So I'm going to kind of squeeze that, let the glue kind of get in there a little bit. We'll let that dry while we start assembling the flower. So then quickly to assemble the flower, it's really just all about layering it up. It's really no super secret sauce, except when you do layer it, you do want to offset, you know, so your green kind of shows behind. And you don't need much, a whole lot of glue. Maybe I'll put my bigger leaf over here. And again, you can use your tool in one, or you can use your tweezers to kind of hold it into place a little bit. And then the very center part, we can poke this into. And then I'm going to leave my two little leaves separate until I go to my actual piece I'm going to add to my card. But I am going to put the little center pieces. These have a special name, and Susan totally knows what it is. And I know that I'm going to say it wrong if I try to say it. So one of you sweet viewers is going to have to check out Susan's official name for these little centerpieces and let me know. I think it starts with a B. Maybe one of your flower people know. You can post it in the comments. Again, this is going to take just a minute to dry. I'm going to let it stand there for a minute. There we go. Now, nobody breathe. I'm going to show you the rest of the card while that dries for just a minute. put my leaf pad away, scooch my dies over here. So we have a new, also a new fun item in the shop, and this is just a great little 6x6 pad of paper. It's called the Christmas Traditions Paper Pad. And speaking of poinsettias, there's one. So many cute little prints and a lot of foiled prints. Did you see that one? That's actually the one I picked. Several of them have the pretty foil, so they shine. So just a great little pad of paper. It's going to give you so many different fun cards. 24 sheets in there, so that's a great piece. So I went ahead and put that on my card front. So I picked the gold foil. I thought, you know, keep it fairly simple. I really want the flower to be the center of attention once I get it on here. But I did pick up this die out of my stash. And this is one of Becca Feakin's. It's called the Holly Frame Gala. I could have just called it S5428, but I don't think that would be too helpful for you guys. But it has this really cute frame inside. It's part of her Cascade collection, so it has a lot of other really cute pieces, little bows, and has a little deer and words and all the fun things. But this frame caught my eye. I thought it was so pretty and delicate. And if I cut it out of white, then it might just be the perfect frame for my flower. So again, that's the Holly Frame Gala, and we'll put the links for that in the video too. So I cut that out and I backed it with a little bit of our brush gold, and I thought, pretty, simple, just really nice to kind of highlight my flower here. So I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit of glue. Actually, I'll take these foam backers off real quick. Might as well attach it to my card. Make sure my glue's not running. Okay, so I'm going to put this up. We're going to leave a little bit of room for the sentiment. Isn't this a sweet die, though? It'd be so great for so many different holiday things. And as my flower dries, I can also kind of fluff it up a little bit, you know, and you're going to mess with it too much. So this is where you have the opportunity to come in and say, okay, do I need an extra little leaf here? That you may not. You may not want one, but I'm looking here and I'm thinking maybe a little green leaf might be sweet right in here. Kind of tuck it in. Tuck it in there nicely. And then to balance it out, let's see. I feel like there's a little gap here, or should I put it up here? Kind of like it down here. And add my little red leaf right in here. Now, truly, I am no expert in season's flowers. I'm considering myself a beginner, but I'm feeling pretty happy about this. I'm kind of liking how it's coming out. So a couple little things to finish it off. We've got this great glimmer die set, and it's got so many sentiments on it. Look at, oh my gosh. It's mini sentiment strips. It has 28 different sentiments on it. Look at them all. So that was kind of hard to choose, but I ended up finding this one that says joyful blessings for all. I thought that was just really sweet. So I cut it out. I glimmer hot folded, of course, cut it out, and then I went ahead and put a little bit of our cutting foam on the back, and I think that's another item that's coming in any day now. And then I figured I'd just give it a little trim. It looks about even. I didn't want to glue it on until I got the flower on and kind of try to decide. Yeah, I think I'll do it right, kind of right on that gold stripe there. I feel like I'm getting my head in the video, hopefully not. When I do go ahead and use the Barely Arts glue, that's what I've been using here. I like that it gives me a little extra second to kind of get this straight. Make sure everything is good on there. There's my little extra glue right there. And what I love about this too is that even if you have a little extra smidge of glue, it dries clear. It's really nice. Does that look centered? I think so. Okay, so really loving this card so far. I did grab my gold mixed gems, and I thought, you know what, we'll go ahead and just add a couple gems. I don't want to put too much because, again, I want the flower to be the total center of attention. So I'm just going to grab a couple small ones and maybe put two here. I feel like it does kind of draw the eye to the sentiment a little bit, which is kind of nice. Hey, gem, go back on there. Maybe one down on the other side. Yeah, I kind of like that. So again, those are the gold mixed gems. Love those. And I think it's pretty done. I'm not going to fluff it up all the way right now. Make sure this guy's standing up. Again, I'm going to let it dry and make sure it gets, you know, real sturdy before I start messing with the petals. But it is quite dimensional already. You can see that it's got, you know, quite a lot of fun height to it. And love the little gold simple background. I think it's enough to make it pop and not take away from the flower. So I really love it. I think it's super fun. So again, that's Susan's Garden Club. That's her, actually Susan's Holiday Flora. I guess I should use the right name for the collection. Susan's Holiday Flora is all of her different holiday dyes. But again, Susan Tierney Coburn is the artist. And before I let you go, I'm gonna quickly show you the card she made for us. And now my card's gonna look kind of sad in comparison. No, it's not gonna look sad. It's just, this is just so beautiful and overwhelming. She's got an extra die in here that I wanted to show you. This is also a beautiful one called Winterberry and Mistletoe. And that's what she's accented her poinsettia with here and here. And if I can have Roy come in a little close, this is something you might not be able to see online. But Susan, after she's done her beautiful little holly leaves here, or winterberry leaves, she's got a little glaze on them. And that gives them a little shine like typically a waxy winterberry or mistletoe would look like. So pretty, right? But look at that card, look at those poinsettias. So beautiful. Susan is the master, that's for sure. But I'm very happy with my poinsettia. I hope that you guys are inspired to try some of Susan's holiday flora as you go along. They make very special cards, definitely keepsakes for that special person in your life. So go ahead and try it, check out the website. And of course there's, I think there's a really good sale going on right now, which we have sales pretty often, but this is one of our big ones. So definitely go to the website at spellbinderspaperarts.com, check it out along with Susan's holiday flora, and have a great weekend crafting. We'll see you soon.